I have consulted Anne on some points of detail.
Anne? Why?
I wish to engage dear Mrs. Clay to reside with us in Bath. Oh. She will be a companion for Elizabeth.
What about Anne? Is Anne not companion enough for you?
Oh, Anne won't be coming, Lady Russell. I had a letter this morning from Sister Mary, who's indisposed and requires Anne's company in Uppercross until her health improves. And since no one will want you in Bath, I'm sure you'd better stay here.
I haven't had time to speak to the gardener, so here is the list of plants that are for Lady Russell. And this is the list of books and music that I must have sent on to Bath. Then you'd better catalogue all the pictures and clear your rubbish out of the storeroom. And someone really ought to visit every house in the parish as I take leave. It is the Elliot way.
I saw him, in fact, in Lyme.
Saw whom?
Mr. Elliot. We met by chance at Lyme.
Perhaps it was Mr. Elliot.
It was.
Well, I don't know. It might have been. Perhaps.
Now that she is settled here, I cannot suppose myself wanted. Perhaps I ought to go home.
There is no need to do that, I assure you. She is nothing to me compared to you.
We wait this morning upon our cousins, Anne, the Dowager Lady de Wimpole and the Honourable Miss Carteret. You'll accompany us, I hope.
If you wish.
A Viscountess. She is a Viscountess!
And family.
I have found Lady de Wimpole's carriage. She will be pleased to convey you home. She has, alas, room only for two.
It is no trouble to me to walk.
Nonsense, you have a cold. Anne can walk.
Well, really, I am content. You might show me that parasol that you mentioned.
You'll ruin your shoes. Anne has thick boots on.
When Captain Wentworth arrives, you must not monopolize him. It's a very bad habit of yours.
You've come at last. I began to think I should never see you. I am so ill, I can hardly speak.
Well, you know, I always cure you when I come to Uppercross.
Oh, Anne. Why could you not have come earlier? It is so unkind.
My dear Mary, I really have had so much to do.
What can you possibly have had to do?
Oh, a great many things, as a matter of fact.
Oh. Well. Dear me.
You haven't asked me one word about our dinner at the pools yesterday.
Yeah, Anne. I'm feeling somewhat improved. I was assuming I do not relapse. Shall we walk after luncheon to the Great House?
Oh, I'd like that.
I ought to have called on you first, of course. You ought to have had the manners to know what is due to you as my sister.
Oh, Anne, will you play when we next give a dance? Well, you play a great deal better than either of us, and we are wild for dancing.
Oh, yes, please, Miss Anne. Oh, Lord bless me, how those fingers of hers can fly about.
I will play too, if you wish. I'm quite as accomplished as Anne.
These people are apt to forget whose daughter I am. Will you have a moment? You must speak to Charles, Anne, and persuade him that I am very, very ill.
Then go along and dine at the Great House. Leave the boy to my care.
Dear me. That's a very good thought.
You don't mind? I too wish to meet Captain Wentworth.
and you, Anne, are by far the properest person to sit with the boy. For you haven't a mother's feelings, have you?
He did inquire after you slightly, as might suit a former slight acquaintance. He was very attentive to me, however.
But that Captain Wentworth is not very gallant towards you, Anne. When Henrietta asked him what he thought of you, he said you were so altered, you would not have known you again.
I had better sit your side, Anne, if you have had your rest.
Well, I think it should be Anne. No one so capable as Anne. You will stay, won't you? Stay and nurse her.
Why should I go away instead of Anne? Anne is nothing to Louisa. I am family. Really, it is too unkind.
Please, Mary.
No. Let Anne take Henrietta.
Curate. You misled me, Shepherd, by the term gentleman. Wentworth the curate's nobody. Quite unconnected. Nothing to do with the Strafford family. Or said I something amiss?
You remember Father, the curate's brother. The sailor.
Let us not pursue it.
Please excuse me. The fire. I became overheated, that's all.
If only I'd had a son. All this might one day have been his. Be what use you can to your sister Mary.
Yes, Father.
Lady Russell will fetch you up to Bath after Christmas. I'm pleased to have you here with us, Anne.
Thank you, Father.
You'll make a fourth at dinner. That must be deemed an advantage. Your looks. You're greatly improved, Anne. You're less thin in your person and in your cheeks, and your complexion's fresher. What are you using? Gowland's lotion?
No, nothing.
Westgate Buildings? And who is this invalid you visit in Westgate Buildings?
A Mrs. Smith.
A Mrs. Smith?
A widow.
A widow, Mrs. Smith. And what is her attraction? That she's old and sickly. Upon my word, Miss Anne Elliot, you have the most extraordinary taste. Everything that revolts other people is inviting to you.
She is a former schoolfellow of mine, Father, and I'm engaged to spend this afternoon with her.
Lady Dalrymple's invitation is most pressing. Could you not put off this old person till tomorrow?
It is the only afternoon for some time which would at once suit her and myself.
So you would snub Lady Dalrymple for Mrs. Smith lodging in Westgate Buildings? You would prefer an everyday Mrs. Smith to your own family connections among the nobility of England and Ireland. Mrs. Smith, such a name.
Captain Wentworth, come in. Come in. What will you play, whist?
I have come on business, Sir Walter.
Business?
My proposal of marriage to your daughter, Anne, has been accepted, and I respectfully request permission to fix a date.
Anne? You want to marry Anne? Whatever for? Once and for all, will you or will you not accompany us to a tea party at our cousins, the Dalrymples?
No, sir, I will not. I have a prior engagement with Mrs. Smith, who is not the only widow in Bath with little to live on and no surname of dignity.